I actually met my husband very close to the same time that I started on the road with WWE. I met Rener actually at the Gracie Academy, which is where I work now. And my sister-in-law now, who was then one of my really good friends, invited me to come take a jiu-jitsu class. And because I had started on the road and I had already had some encounters on the road traveling by myself, I thought, absolutely, I want to learn this stuff. Not to mention, I can use it in the ring as well. So I was all about it. I went in for my first jiu-jitsu class, and Rener was my instructor. I knew right away that this was a really special man. April 13th, 2014, that was the day that Rener and I finally got married. My wedding was a dream come true for me. I feel like I couldn't imagine anything going better. All the people that I loved were there. It was in California, it was in Santa Barbara, which is beautiful. It was perfect day, perfect weather. You know, it's not just two people coming together, it's two families coming together. The Gracie family is known for being the family that created Gracie or Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Rener's grandfather, Elio Gracie, is the man who took Japanese Jiu-Jitsu and made all of these modifications, and that was the birth of Gracie Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So pretty much as soon as I started training Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, one of my first thoughts was, why doesn't every woman in the world know this stuff?
I'm gonna show you the first move I ever learned as a student under Rener Gracie. And I'm on top.
The abilities that it gave me, I felt like it leveled the playing field in terms of me being able to defend myself against somebody much stronger than I am.
Lock it up. You see the triangle? One, two, three. My legs are clogging his arteries right now. I hold his head down and squeeze. And he goes to sleep. And then to jail.
And then when the opportunity came for me to start teaching with Rener, he thought it's really important, I think, to have a woman on board, especially if we're going to be teaching women. So the academy had never had a female instructor before, so it was really meaningful. And the women's program is called Women Empowered, and his father created it originally. We've kind of taken it a lot further in terms of really understanding how these scenarios go down, how these assaults take place.
So I walk in, hey, what time is it?
Hey, back up.
Now there is a very clear boundary. If I say, no, I just want him to know.
Excuse me, hey.
He has no respect if he keeps walking right now.
We're saying you don't have to be an MMA fighter. You just have to be concerned about your, you know, your personal safety. Just want to feel like you could handle a bad situation if it came your way.
Yes, there we go.
It goes much deeper than just self-defense. This is true empowerment, and this is confidence in themselves and in each other.
Teaching is actually something I really love, and the feeling you get when someone comes to you and they don't know anything, and then they've come to you for several weeks and several months, and all of a sudden they are completely skilled and they're confident, and you see it translating to other areas of their life, that's when you say, I'm really making a difference.